I don't think Ed can run anything anywhere. I don't think they have personnel. I think what personnel they have is generally not too competent, ex-school teachers and things of that kind. A third of their people short out there. They advertise and trying to get them. I don't think that they're the type that can take over when the troops move out and so on and so forth. And even if you had to recall somebody like Fred Anderson or someone that has both a military and civilian background, I think it would be much to be preferred to the way we're handling it now. And I don't think Lodger's any administrator. I think Porter's just going to be his deputy as long as he's there. So I think we've got to find some new way to do it. Now, how to do it without having a blow-up is Mr. Anthony's problem, and I leave that up to you and Comer, but I am concerned that we're not any better off than we were 3 years ago, maybe not as well. And I do have a respect for the military, or I would have respect for a chief of police that's had some training in protecting people from coming in with terror at night and things of that kind. And I don't think a school teacher's got much. I think temporarily it's kind of like a New Orleans disaster with Inez. You've got to have somebody that can command, take charge until you can teach the people, until they can grow into it. And we just got to recognize that. We can't get the civilian personnel. We don't have experience, training, or anything else. And I think that Westmoreland's ultimately not going to do his job just to win a military victory. As soon as he wins it, let them take over behind him. So you have to find some way to pull it together. If you make your recommendations, we'll try to get them together here.
Very good. All right.